super simp.
Hello, sir.
Uh-oh, I think he caught me.
What are you doing up there, super simp?
Graffiti, sir.
Graffiti? Super simp, please come down.
Yes, sir.
Ha! Super simp, you know that graffiti is damaging to other people's property.
I know it's wrong, sir, but it was a dare. Everyone else in the Superhero Academy has done it. So, I was just following their example.
Super Sim, to be a superhero takes courage. I know how tempting it is to follow what other people do, but that's why it takes so much courage to do what's right. And there will be many times in your life when a group is behaving in a way that is wrong and is tempting you to do the same. But you're responsible for yourself. It takes courage not to follow the crowd.
Yes, sir. I'm sorry. Please forgive me.
You're forgiven. You're going to have to clean off later, though. This is a good lesson, Super Sim. As you know, at our Superhero Academy, we train people of all ages to face their fears and live lives of courage and make a difference in this world. Do you know what courage is?
Courage is being brave enough to do what is right, even when you're afraid.
That's right. Hey, let's play a quick game to help us understand.
All right.
Boys and girls, welcome to our Superhero Academy. Thank you for joining us. Please help Super Sim and I with this game. This is part of your superhero training. The game is What Takes Courage? I'll ask a question and you need to choose the response and see which takes the most courage. Are you ready, boys and girls? Are you ready, Super Sim?
Yes!
Which takes more courage? Listen carefully now. Everyone is saying mean things about a girl in your class. We've experienced that one. Is it A, join in, B, laugh at the jokes, or what about C, Super Sim? Don't join, either be silent or say, that's mean, stop it.
Well, it would be kind of funny, but I think it's C. Don't join, either be silent or say, that's mean, stop it.
You're so right, Super Sim. That's a lot of wisdom. Hey, what about this one? Imagine this, Super Sim. You're at a sleepover party and someone gets out a movie that is age-rated 16 years old, but you're not 16 years old yet. Which takes more courage? Is it A, watch the movie anyway, or B, not watch the movie and go to bed, or C, watch half of the movie and close your eyes for the bad parts?
That's a tough one. But I think B, not watch the movie and go to bed.
You're absolutely right. How about this one? This one is also an interesting one. You're writing a test that you didn't study very hard for, and there's a question you don't know the answer for. Everyone is sharing the answers because the teacher went out. Which takes more courage? Is it A, don't cheat, but possibly not get the right answer and get a lower mark? Or B, look over at your friend's test paper? Or C, ask your friend to share the answer with you because the teacher is out of the room anyway?
I'd say I would choose C. Ask my friend to share the answer with me because the teacher is not in the room anyway.
That's wrong, Sim. The correct answer is actually A. Don't cheat, but possibly not get the right answer and get a lower mark. That one would take the most courage. Well done, everyone. Seems like you really know what it takes to be courageous. Well done, Super Sim. You did so well.
Thank
Sometimes you might get it right, and some other days you might not feel very courageous. But hey, that's okay. As we grow and as we get to know God more, He will help us to be truly courageous.
Do you know anyone in the Bible who was very courageous?
Yes, I do. Let me share a Bible story with you about two guys who showed a lot of courage. Are you ready, everyone?
Yes!
We're continuing God's big story together as we look at what happened with God's people, the Israelites. You might remember that God promised to bless the whole world through Abraham's family.
Yes, I remember. And Abraham's family grew over many generations. And along the way, they became known as the Israelites. We've seen how God rescued the Israelites from slavery in Egypt. We saw how God made a way for them by parting the waters of the Red Sea. The people traveled through the desert toward the land God had prepared for them, which was where Abraham had lived long before. Along the way, God provided food and water for the people. God also gave them rules to show them how to love God and love others.
Well remembered. Now, finally, the people arrived at the land of Canaan, which was the promised land. And this was about 2 years after they had crossed the Red Sea. Do you remember who the leader of the Israelites was?
Moses.
Yes. And God spoke to Moses and told him to send some of the men to explore the land as undercover spies. And God said,
"Send some men to explore the land of Canaan. I am giving it to the Israelites. Send one leader from each of Israel's tribes."
So Moses chose a leader from each of the 12 tribes of Israel. And Moses told these 12 leaders that he wanted them to explore the land of Canaan.
"You gentlemen, please find out what's the land like. Are the people who live there strong or weak? Are there just a few of them or a lot of them? Is the land good or bad?"
The men went off on their journey. For about 6 weeks, they traveled through the country. And the men saw the places where Abraham and his family had lived hundreds of years before. And they found some fruit that they could bring back to Moses like he had asked them to. And they cut off a branch of grapes that was so large that it had to be carried on a pole between two men. After 40 days, it was time for these 12 men to return to the Israelite camp. The men reported to Moses and the rest of the Israelites. They explained that the land was good and full of milk and honey. The fruit was incredible too. The grapes were huge, but the news wasn't all good. The men had seen that, hey, the people who already lived in the land were powerful, and their cities had high walls.
"We went to the land where you sent us. It is a land where much food grows. Here is some of its fruit. But the people who live there are strong, and their cities are walled and large."
"We should go up and take the land for ourselves. We can do it."
"We can't attack those people. They are stronger than we are. The land will eat us up. All the people we saw there are very tall, and we look like grasshoppers to them."
The 12 spies were so scared, Super Sim. Well, I should say most of the 12 men were scared. There were two men who trusted God and were not worried about what they had seen. Their names were Joshua and Caleb. Caleb interrupted the men and said, "We should go up and take the land. We can certainly do it." But again, the other men said that the people who lived in the land were too strong for them. These men spread a bad report among the Israelites. They said, "We're like little bitty grasshoppers compared to these strong and big people." I bet you can imagine what happened next, Super Sim. The other Israelites totally panicked. They listened to the men who said that it was hopeless for them to enter the land, even though God had led them this far. The people whined and complained and cried out that it would be better if they went back to Egypt. Joshua and Caleb tried to encourage the people. Listen to what they said.
"We passed through the land and checked it out. It was very good. If the Lord is pleased with us, He'll lead us into that land. It's a land that has plenty of milk and honey. He'll give it to us, but don't refuse to obey Him. And don't be afraid of the people of the land."
But the people wouldn't listen to Joshua and Caleb, Super Sim. Then something truly incredible happened.
What happened?
Oh, the glory of God appeared in the tent of meeting. All the Israelites could see Him.
I bet that calmed things down in a hurry.
God said to Moses,
"How long will these people not respect me? How long will they refuse to believe in me?"
Moses begged God to have mercy and forgive the people for what they had done. and God agreed to forgive them. But there was a consequence. God said,
"Not one of these people will see the land I promised to give them. But my servant Caleb has a different spirit. He follows me with his whole heart. So I will bring him into the land he went to."
God would allow Joshua to enter the land as well. Joshua and Caleb were the only ones, Super Sim, who had the courage to trust God and believe that God would help them enter Canaan.
Wow.
But in the meantime, Joshua and Caleb and the rest of the Israelites, they couldn't go into Canaan. They had to wait and wander in the wilderness for almost 40 years. Mm-hmm. By then, only Joshua and Caleb were still living to lead the new generation, their children, into the land God had promised. And when those 40 years had finally passed, Super Sim, Joshua led the Israelites into Canaan, which was the promised land. With God's help, they defeated the city of Jericho.
Yeah.
The walls fell down and the Israelites won the battle.
Wow! It took a lot of courage for Joshua and Caleb to stand up when the other Israelites were starting to panic.
Yeah, and these two guys tried to encourage the others to do what God had asked them to do, which was to enter the land of Canaan. They trusted God, Super Sim, that he was with them, but it was no use. The other Israelites were too scared to listen. And you know, sometimes courage means standing up when other people are afraid. It could mean doing what is right when others are doing something wrong. Remember, you can do what is right even when others are afraid. Let's pray and ask God to help us with that. Father God, thank you that you are always with us. Please give us the courage to stand up and live the way you've called us to live, by loving other people and looking out for what they need. Fill us with your spirit so we can live the way we should, even when others are afraid. We love you and we pray these things in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So what do we need to remember today?
You can do what is right, even when others are afraid.
That's right, Super Sim. And our memory verse for this month is Joshua 1, verse 9. It's something God said to Joshua when Joshua became the leader of the Israelites after Moses had died. God told Joshua, "Be strong and brave. Do not be afraid. Do not lose hope. I am the Lord your God. I will be with you everywhere you go." Joshua 1, verse 9. That's why we can have true courage, Super Sim, because God is with us just like he was with Joshua. Let's say it again together one more time.
Be strong and brave. Do not be afraid. Do not lose hope. I am the Lord your God. I will be with you everywhere you go. Joshua 1, verse 9.
What a great verse.
Yeah.
I'm going to remember that. Now it's time to praise and worship God together, boys and girls.
Salani gahle bangani.
Bye.
I'm too afraid to lose. I feel unqualified for what you're calling me to. The Lord with your strength, I've got no excuse. 'Cause broken people are exactly who you use. So give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David, Lord, be my defense. So I can face my giants with confidence. You took a shepherd boy and made him a king. So I'm gonna trust you and give you everything. I'll be a conqueror, 'cause you fight for me. I'll be a champion, claiming your victory. So give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David, Lord, be my defense.
so I can face my giants with confidence. I'm gonna sing and shout and shake the walls. Won't stop until I see them fall. Gonna stand up, step up when you call. Jesus, Jesus. I'm gonna sing and shout and shake the walls. Won't stop until I see him fall. Gonna stand up, step out when you call. Jesus, so give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David. Lord, be my defense, so I can face my giants with confidence. So give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David. Lord, be my defense, so I can face my giants with confidence. I'll face my giants with confidence.